Hello there. Welcome. My name is Sarah Finn, and we're going to be painting in Tiltbrush today. Thanks for joining me. If you've caught my previous streams or episodes, you might notice that this is just a recorded episode on YouTube. To be quite frank, sometimes VR can cause headaches and things like that, so I like to take a couple days break. And today I wanted to be more casual about my session, so here we are in a pre-recorded episode. I'm listening to NXS, one of the artists I listened to in a previous episode, and you can catch my work at PolyGoogle under Sarah Finn. You can also catch it on Instagram under Machine Age Maya, all one word. And today I'm going to be painting Bjork. If you don't know who Bjork is, she's an Icelandic pop singer and diva who's very eccentric, has cool style. And after asking my buddies what I should paint as far as like what amazing picture of her, I picked the Homogenic cover from earlier in her career. I already started the layout of this painting, as you'll see when I hop into VR, but I wanted to kind of give people an idea of the way I work on faces sometimes. I gotta fit my glasses in my headset. All right. So we have these lovely reference pictures of Bjork that I've already imported, and they're scalable, which is great. And what I like to do is set up a plane for my illustration, and you can see that I've got it set up with sort of a backdrop of some soft highlight brush. So what I do is once I've set this up and started some strokes, I can just grab this and pull it away and see what I've done. And then just back click and it snaps right back into place. That way, as I paint each part, I can pull away and sort of check my work and see if it's where I want. So I've already sort of set up where the base of her face is going to be, and I've been using the mirror brush. Sorry, not mirror brush, but rather the mirror tool. It's just a thing set up that copies all of your strokes to either side. I am going to reposition the unilit hull base of her face. As you can see, it's slightly offset from my mirror brush, but I'll be doing that once I have all of these other strokes I'm going to add up top. So as you can see, I've worked on her eyes a little bit, as well as her eyebrow. And I've started the eyebrow with kind of a light color stroke, because as you can see from the reference image, let's grab this and bring it in like this so you can see them both. As you can see, she's got her eyebrows sort of lightened in this look, and towards the end of the eyebrow, the tail of it, you can see it's a little darker also in the shadow and lighting of this photo. So when I do faces, I like to use the unilit hull. I'll sort of mime what I've done so far. So you would go into your brushes and grab the unilit hull. You'd also want to use your dropper and grab the color. What would mostly be the most mid-tone color is going to be the one you want to go for. Not as bright as this, but not necessarily as dark as that. Something like this would be a good mid-tone to use your dropper tool and select. And then from there, with the unilit hull brush, what I do is I just trace the outline of the face, and I do it just behind my reference image. And I might, you know, check my work and do it a couple times until it really has the edge of the face that I want, and I'll kind of try to go for definition in the cheekbone and the jaw, as well as get a nice round chin. And that way you have sort of like a canvas. You've got your floating 2D canvas in space, and you can sort of see that from behind here, right? And whip that around again, and you can see on top of that I have these strokes that are done in a more brush-like style, and the brush I used for that is blah blah blah, let's see, pinched marker if I remember right. And you can see that it's got these tapered ends. And depending on the shape of the shadow contours, you can pick different brushes to have different edges. But what's nice about all of these in this column, they're unilit. They don't have any shaders on them. So you can put them next to one another and you're not gonna see the lines differentiated. See how that's all one shade of the same blue blob, even though it's multiple strokes? Yeah, so that's what's nice about using any of these three brushes when you're working on the face and doing shadows and contours. Let's see, so I've got my Bjork and I have her hair. These buns are made of another hull brush, but that brush is the shiny hull brush. What I'm gonna do with the shiny hull brush is use it as a base for these buns. I'm gonna take a lofted brush and create like a semicircle C shape like that and create many of them copied next to each other and then select them and place it around this bun to create that more of a hair texture that you see. Let's see, so I'm gonna go ahead and select these buns and I'm gonna make them just a tiny bit smaller because my lofted brush is gonna take up some of the volume. And I want to leave space so that once I got all those strokes layered on top, that it's not bigger than the profile in the reference. Something like that would be good. Maybe this one can be bigger. You can see her bun gets bigger off of this photograph's edge there. All right, that'll work. Okay, so we got a lovely Bjork. I'm gonna go in and do a little bit on her nose and show you how you can create almost like it reminds me of vector colored art. If you've seen my subway piece and you've looked at the details on the nun face, it kind of has that quality with the gradient on it, which is really fun. I like that. So we're gonna try to do that again with this. Let's look at which brush we have. Let's try a tapered marker. So I'm gonna come in pretty close. So there's a difference. I wanna show you scale-wise, this is a cool thing, practically in Tiltbrush. So if you use your middle fingers and you select the side button on your controller and you go to scale, one of the things that you can do to get really close to your object but still maintain, pardon me as I goof around with this. You can see how I can bring it up close, but then I can also scale it so I get big. So it's both the added effect of how close you are to it, and how big you scale it. You can probably see in the little picture in picture how far I'm spreading my arms when I pull it like that. Anyhow. And one of the things you can also do is bring your hands together and bring your composition up. So like this, I don't know. You can sort of see the reactivity there. But if you actually play around a tilt brush yourself, those things become kind of useful when you're trying to get close to a piece. You can also rescale all your stuff with the select tool. Like if I wanted to grab this, any of this, and my, you know, reference itself, you can see it's highlighted when I do that. You can scale all that stuff at any point, which is cool. So I'm gonna go in here and sort of play with some brush strokes and try to get what I would like for a nose. That's cute. Let's try some highlights down here. Oh, but I want the mirror tool. Sometimes you gotta be picky with which color you actually pick. That's funny. But, you know, I might think I want this because that's where the color's placed. But it's picking a single pixel. And if I were to pick one of these sort of pink shades, it's not really gonna give me what I want. It's gonna be way too pronounced against the backdrop. So I gotta go for something else. Takes a minute to get the right color sometimes. That's a little bit better. Let's try something like that. Yeah, let's try that for now. And we'll add in the darker part of her nostril. See if that helps. Let's use a nice neutral for that. And then we can use a pinker tone. Not quite as dark as you see here, because that would be ridiculous. Maybe something like that. Oh, that's nice. Look at that. That's better. I want to add in a little bit. Ooh, it's getting freaky. These are nice details. And what's also nice is because it's dimensional, you can take some of your strokes, like this one right here I just did, and I tucked it at an angle behind this one. And so you can see the beginning of that stroke sort of underneath this right here. It's kind of a nice effect because then their edges really like dovetail from this perspective, and it gives you this nice transition. I don't know, something to keep in mind. It looks like it's pulled away. Oh, I like that tone. Let's use more of that color in other places. Let's use it down by her lip. Let's see if that works well. Oh yeah. I'm gonna go in there though and use the recolor tool. I'm gonna go into the color that I had, and I noticed that it was a little too close to the unilit whole backdrop, but I'm gonna just make it a tiny bit lighter and see if it makes them stand out just a tiny bit more. Try it on one side. Oh, that's nice. I can actually see a little bit, but I don't want there to be that much definition. You can see that it's a good blend on the reference photo. The makeup is really blended. So let's just see if we can recolor some of the metal strokes that look weird. Maybe we can pick an in-between tone there. Go from the recolor back to the brush tool and that. Well, it's not quite as blendy as might help this. I could just get that volumetric quality with a soft highlight. I think that's what I'm gonna do instead. This one right here on the first page. What's cool about this brush is that it's really bright when you're in the lighter scale, but if you bring down your hue or whatever saturation to a darker tone, it becomes a lot lighter. It's not, well, when I say light, I mean it's more see-through and translucent, and it's a softer version of that stroke. Not light as in, you know, brightness, but light as in touch. So you can see it makes a pretty highlight of the lower tones here. That way, if I was more delicate about it, I could create a volumetric lip that's white on white. Sometimes when you drive your brush through geometry like that, you can see the edge of where it goes through, and it kind of makes it polygonal looking, so you want to stay above any of your other strokes or geometry. Ooh, that's pretty. That's kind of where I'd like to go with it. I should do it more in the middle though, by this kabuki lip, rather than at the outer edge. Go back some strokes. Just do it like this. I'm probably gonna keep this video relatively short today. And I'll do pretty much a whole series on faces. I mean, as a traditional analog artist, that's the thing I focused a lot on and what I spent time trying to translate into Tiltbrush, so I think that's a good place to start as far as sharing what I've learned. But yeah, feel free to comment if there's anything you've seen in my PolyGoogle that you want me to show you how I did. But once I've done all these sort of contours with the unilit brushes to do the shading and stuff, as you can see, I've got a little bit going on there. I like to use the soft highlight brush to do highlights on cheek. And I use the, like I said, the very low end. It almost looks like I'm painting in black, right? But because this is a soft highlighter, it's just a very see-through, soft touch version of that bright highlight. And I'll go in and sort of paint a little bit of dimensionality on the face. That's a little pink, so let's go ahead and make it more neutral. See if that helps. Go a tiny bit to the green. Maybe that'll help it look more neutralized. Yeah, that's nice. It's a little better. So at first that's going to look subtle when you mess around with using the highlight. And you'll notice after you've done a stroke or two too much that it really shows up. It's bright. It layers on itself. So you can see that looks a little streaky. So you want to just be careful as you layer them. That's nicer. And I also kind of just like it plain. Let's give her nose some highlight. And when you've got the mirror, if you're on the seam, it's going to be doubling up. So just be aware that it's going to turn out brighter looking there. I want to be careful not to make her skin look too dewy. As much as I like it in terms of modern makeup looks, it's not the way this makeup look is. I'm also going to go in and just delete this little stroke by. Because I think I want to do that in a soft highlight as well. Let's do that. hand fanny, y'all. Well, from there, that's kind of a nice start with the face. And once I get other details in, it'll be easier to see what I need to do with it. So from here, I'm actually gonna just do something fun to, I don't know, lighten up the concentration. I'm gonna go ahead and grab a disco brush, which is a fun animated sparkly brush. I'm gonna use the dropper and grab this gold color. See how it looks. Yeah, it needs to be a little bit more yellow. So I'll just push this palette to yellow. That's a little better. I can always recolor them too. So this is currently mirrored. I don't know if I want to maintain the mirror because it might affect the look of the circle. Yeah, I'm gonna just take the mirror tool off. I'm just gonna like play around with these for a moment. That's a nice stroke. So sometimes if I don't feel like I have a steady enough hand to do a bunch of strokes that steady, I'll just take the one that turned out good and I'll copy it and I'll just position them next to each other like that. And I can also change the scale so these can change the same way for the ones in the reference do. Then you can grab multiple of them, reposition it or copy them and then tuck that up higher. Yeah. I'll copy these. Make them a tiny bit bigger, not much. These a little bit bigger yet. Kind of nice. That makes it quicker and easier to do instead of having multiple strokes. Yeah. So I've got the start of this neat little homogenic album tribute. As you can see, I can make the stroke bigger for these larger rings at the bottom. Something like that. Cool. Well, thanks for tuning in. My name is Sarah Finn, and you can find, like I said before, my stuff at Sarah Finn on PolyGoogle. You can find it on Instagram as Machine Age Maya. And you can find my Patreon at patreon.com/therafin. But I'll catch you later this week with another VR painting session. And I haven't quite decided what we'll do, but it'll be fun. If you have any suggestions, let me know in the comments. But yeah, thanks for tuning in. Bye.